In today's video, we're going to look at several tips for working with apps on the iPad. This includes how we can move multiple apps at the same time, how we can hide our home screens or even remove them, how we can set up accessibility options on a per-app basis. I also have a few other ones that I'll be sharing with you. Now, before we get started, if you like this video, stick around till the end. I'll have a little bit more about me and how you can support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's get back over to my tips on working with apps for the iPad. The first tip we're going to look at is how we can move multiple apps. So I have here four different home screens. Now, what I would like to do is combine a couple of these. If we look here, you're going to see that I have this home screen here with a number of apps and this one here. I could easily combine these by moving these over to my other home screen. Now, one way of doing that is by long pressing on it till we get to the jiggle mode. And then I can take one and I drag it over to the edge and move it where I want. But I have to do that for each one of these apps. Well, what we can also do is grab all of these apps together and move them at the same time. To do that, what we do is we long press again to get into the jiggle mode. And then I just go and grab one app. I'm going to grab this app here. And then I just slightly move it. So I just have to move it. So I take it and I move it. Now what I do is I tap on these apps individually. So I'm just going to go ahead and tap on the first one here. And you can see that it moves it over into this pile. So let's go ahead and do that with the next three. And now I have all five of those apps. And when I move my finger around, it's grabbing all five of those. So now all I need to do is just go over to this home screen here. I let go. And those five apps are now on that home screen. So that's our first tip. We can move multiple apps at the same time. The next tip we're going to focus on is the app library. I'm going to show you a few different tricks for the app library. First of all, what is the app library? Well, when you're on the last home screen here, when you swipe over to the left, so I just swipe over to the left, what it's going to do is it's going to go to my app library. Now, right now I'm looking at these apps categorized. They're in different folders. These folders are based on what the developer submits their app to Apple in. So they would have to say this is a game or this is a social media or maybe this is a utility. Well, maybe what you'd like to do is view these in a list. You still don't want to see them in the folder. That's how I like to do it. I like to view all of these in a list in alphabetical order, much like how I view my apps on my Mac. Well, in order to do that, what you do is you just swipe down. So all I have to do is swipe down, and there they are in alphabetical order. And I can even tap on a letter here to get to a different app here. That's my favorite way of viewing my apps. So what I like to do is actually keep a combination of my home screens here along with that app library. What do I mean by that? Well, I like to keep a couple of home screens, so I have all of my main apps here. Maybe I have some secondary apps here. And then after that, what I would like to do is go to my app library. So I have to get rid of all of these. Or maybe what I'd like to do, I would just like to have one home screen with my main apps, and then when I swipe, I can see my app library. Well, that means what I have to do is I have to get rid of all of these individually. And when you do, it'll reduce that home screen. So I would long press, and then I tap on the minus for each one of these to get rid of it. Well, there's an easier way. What we can do is we can hide these home screens. We can also remove them. All we have to do is just press on this button here when it's in the jiggly mode. So my apps are jiggling. It's in the jiggly mode. I press on it. And then from here, what I'm able to do is hide my home screens. We can see that we actually have one home screen hidden already. How do I know it's hidden? Because there's no check mark here. So what I could do is I could just tap on these here to hide them. Now those are hidden. And when I tap on done, I'm going to have one home screen. So now if I want to get to my app library, what do I do? All I have to do is just swipe over to the left. I'm at my app library, swipe down, they're in alphabetical order. I go back, I'm looking at my one home screen. If I want to add another home screen in there, long press, and then I tap on this again, And then from here, I can tap on any one of my home screens that I want to add in there. So now I'm at two home screens. So I swipe again, app library. So that's an easy way of managing your home screens. Now we can remove them as well. If we long press to get in the jiggly mode and we press on this again, instead of hiding them, what I can do is I can actually remove them. Now we can only remove home screens that are hidden. You're going to see that I can't hide this one. That's because that one is shown. So if I tap on the check mark here, now I can hide it. Or I'm sorry, I can remove it. Now when you do remove a home screen, what it does is it keeps all of your apps. So they're going to be in the app library. It doesn't delete any apps. But what it will do is it will remove any bookmarks. Let's go ahead and tap on the minus. I'm going to tap on remove here. And you're going to see I have another dialog that says keep bookmarks. So what is this? Well, when you save a web page to your home screen, you can save web pages to your home screen, so it's almost like it's an app. It's actually a bookmark. So what it's going to do is it's going to remove that website that is saved as an app. Also, if you have any shortcuts that are saved to your home screen, it'll remove those. Those are bookmarks as well. So generally speaking, I don't necessarily like to remove them. What I will generally do is I will just go and hide them. I would just cancel this, and then I would hide which ones I ever want. Then you can easily bring them back, including all of your bookmarks. Now you can also rearrange these by dragging them around. So if you wanted to rearrange them, you can do that too. So if you have a lot of them, you want to remove a couple of them, go ahead and move them around to arrange them how you want. So then you just have a couple of home screens and then it'll go over to your app library. When you are done, you just have to tap on done and any changes that you made will now be reflected on your iPad. Now you may know this, but you can also use Spotlight to search for apps. So this is going to be a quick tip. All I have to do is just swipe down to get my Spotlight and then I just type in the app that I'm searching for. So I have an app called Freeform. All I have to do is just type in here Freeform. Maybe I don't know where it is. Well, when I type in Freeform, we can see we have the app there. I can just tap on it to open it up. Now we can also do the opposite. We can remove an app from our home screen and keep it in the app library. You probably have seen this when you remove an app. Let's go over here to this app here. When I long press on it, and then I go and remove the app, I have an option to delete the app, or what I can do is I can remove it from the home screen. When you delete the app, it removes it from the iPad. If you want to keep that app in your app library, maybe it's something that you're going to use down the road, what you can do is you can remove it from the home screen and then it'll move it over to your app library, but it'll remove it from the home screen. So this will free up room on your home screen. You'll still have the app on the iPad though. So let's go ahead and remove from the home screen here. We can see it is no longer on my home screen, but when I go to my app library here and I go to Express, you're going to see that it is here. So I still have the app on my iPad. It's just not in one of my home screens here. So that's another way of organizing your home screens with your favorite apps. You can remove them individually, still have them on your iPad, just remove them from the home screen. Now we can also have multiple instances of an app on our iPad. What do I mean by that? Well, if we go back over to my iPad, you're going to see that I have several home screens here. I unhid them earlier. So I have several home screens here. Now what I would like to do is have Zoom here on this home screen, and then I would also like to have it on this home screen here. I don't want to have it on every home screen. Maybe this is for social media or maybe for presentation, and then the first one here is my favorite apps. I don't need it on every home screen, and I don't need it in my dock. I don't want to have it on my dock either. Well, what we can do is we can create another instance of this on that second home screen. First thing that we have to do is we have to go to the home screen we want to add it on. This is the easiest way. And then we use that search method. So I'm going to swipe down and I search for Zoom. And we have Zoom here. So I just take this and I drag it to this home screen. And we can see we have a green plus there. And now I've added it to that home screen. So now we can see we have it here. And it is not in my dock anywhere. It is not on this page here. And it is on this page. so we can have multiple instances of it. We can also do the same thing from the app library. If I go all the way to the app library, I can take an app, drag it, and place it where I want. And it's going to create another instance of it. Now, when you do this, it does not actually duplicate the app. When I open up Zoom here, it's the same Zoom that is here. If I were to duplicate books, it's not going to be a different books app. It's going to open up to the same book. If I duplicate or create another instance for Safari, you can see I have two of them here. When I open up both of those, it's going to go to the same web page. So it's not a duplicate. All it is what I would call another instance of it. So if you want to have an app on multiple home screens, you can easily create another instance of it through search or through the app library. Now, the last tip we're going to look at is per app settings. You probably know that you can change the size of the text on your iPad. But when you do this, what it does is it changes the size of the text for every app. Well, maybe what you'd like to do is make one app the text a little larger, or maybe you need to make it a little bit smaller, but you don't want to do this for the entire iPad. This is what per app settings are. It allows you to change these type of settings on a per app basis. To do this, what we need to do is we need to go to our settings app. This is an accessibility option. So I tap on settings and I swipe up until I find accessibility. When I go to accessibility, instead of going over to all of these settings here, maybe Zoom or anything like that, these are all global. Any changes I make here are going to be for the entire iPad. I want to make them on a per app basis. So what I need to do is I need to swipe up until we get to per app settings. This is where we can set it up on a per app basis. So I just tap on this, and then from here I go and add an app. You can see I have a couple of them set already. Let's go ahead and add the Messages app. So I just swipe, or I can type in here Messages. Say I wanted to make the text a little larger for Messages only. Tap on it, and now we have Messages here. Now all I need to do is just tap on it, and then from here I can change the display and text size, make it bold, make it larger, make it smaller for this app only. I also have transparency options. I can increase the contrast. Any changes that I make here are only going to affect Messages. They will not affect any other app. So if we go back, you saw that I had it here for a couple of apps. Let's go over to Books. Let's say I wanted to make a change to this. All I have to do is just go in here and make the change. When you are finished, you just go back, and now those changes are made just for that app. To remove the settings, all you have to do is just swipe over to the left and you can delete it. What it's going to do is delete those per app settings. So any changes that you made are now going to be brought back to the global settings. So if you made the text size larger for the entire iPad, that app will now reflect that. So in addition to making changes for the entire iPad, you can also do this on a per app basis. So those are some tips on how to work with apps on the iPad. We can grab multiple apps and move them. We can hide or even remove home screens. We can rearrange them. We have the app library where we can see our apps in alphabetical view. And then we can also set up our accessibility options on a per app basis. So there's a lot of things that you can do with our apps. You can even create multiple instances of an app. So that's how we work with our apps on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, or even share it with your family or friends. You can also check out my website. Even though I have about 450 videos on YouTube at this recording, I have over 2,000 on my website. I've been building my website a lot longer than I have my YouTube channel. My website is danstutorials.com, and you can view all of the videos on there for free. If you would like to support my efforts, you can become a member. When you become a member of my site, not only are you helping support a small business, but you're going to get all of the ads or all of the videos ad-free. You're going to be able to access my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple genius. And then I also host websites two or three times a month, and you have access to those. So if you like what you see here, check out my membership options over at Dan's Tutorials. It's a way that you can support me as well as a small business. So that's how you can work with your apps on the iPad.